Okay guys, so this is gonna be an interesting video. I am actually getting on a plane, and another plane, and then another plane, and I'm actually headed somewhere for a very exciting and secret location for a secret reason, which you're not gonna know, until the end of this video, so you could just skip ahead. But you're not gonna do that because you guys have to come here and stare at my pretty face for the full 10, 15, who am I kidding? It's gonna be like 25 minutes as always. But one thing I wanted to do, which is gonna be interesting for this video, because I have so much travel time, literally, I'm thinking of doing 3 or 4 cities, 40, 35 hours of total travel time with all these layovers and stuff. I wanted to do a one massive Q&A. So I'm actually gonna take a photo right now, put it on my Instagram, put it on my Snapchat, all that stuff. And I'm gonna be trying to answer a few questions in each one of my pit stops. We're gonna answer a question in Gold Coast, we're gonna answer a question or two in Melbourne, we're gonna answer a question or two in Dubai, and then we're gonna answer a question or two in my final destination, which, again, you guys are not gonna know unless you skip ahead 10 minutes. I'm gonna be showing you guys my personal recommendations when it comes to traveling, especially traveling whilst dieting. It's very easy for you to end up eating simply too little, in which case you are way too low on protein intake, or you eat too much crap. It's not like, hey, high protein chicken teriyaki. No, you're gonna end up eating at McDonald's, you're gonna end up eating at, like, you know, pizza, whatever you find in the airport. So, my personal recommendations. Number one, a lot of snacks. I got a whole box of protein bars, literally just for this trip. So I'm just gonna bring it. These are dark chocolate and berry flavored Pro Bars. So each one of them has about, it's like 25, 30 grams of protein, which is fantastic. Also, I am bringing just a regular shaker cup. This has about 30 grams of actual whey protein powder, which I'll be able to drink, you know, throughout the day. But then afterwards, I'll have this and I'll just use it as a water bottle because water at an airport costs like $14.
Okay guys, so step one, Gold Coast. Got a flight in about an hour. 30-hour journey, let's get started.
There's so many questions, guys, and once again, I apologize if I can't get to all of them. So the first one is, what is your PR on the bench press, deadlift, and overhead press? Number one, do you not care about the squat? Are you trying to infer something? Are you trying to say that with these legs, I don't squat or I can't squat? On the deadlift, the best I ever got, I think it was 530 pounds. I did in a powerlifting meet in early 2016. On the bench press, I had a 335 touch and go. I did that with Colossus Fitness early 2016. On the overhead press, I had 215 pounds, which is so annoying because I've always wanted to overhead press two plates, which is 225. So I was 10 pounds short. But to be honest, guys, when it comes to the overhead press, it's one of those lifts where it's very easy for your form to buckle and break down when you're trying to lift more weight. You guys have seen this before, right? When someone puts on way too much weight, something that they can't do, or at least they can't do properly, they start overhead pressing and then they kind of start leaning back. And then it's almost as if they take a vertical press, the overhead press, which is supposed to be using your anterior deltoids, which are right here. And because you're like so far back, it almost turns it into a standing incline bench press. And your back is just like this crazy, like, question mark. I'm not a big fan of that. That's why I've actually been going a lot more in terms of top set PRs with the overhead press. For example, the most I've ever done on 135 with the overhead press, 17. Yeah, 17 reps is the most I've ever done, 135 pounds on the overhead press. In the one rep max, I'm a lot more concerned with overall set rep volume strength as I am to just sheer pushing power. Again, because I think it's one of those lifts where it's very easy to break down on your form and potentially injure yourself really badly. All right guys, next question. This one's a little bit more philosophical and general, not necessarily training based, but I want this Q&A to be half-half. So like half nutrition, training, kind of like technical stuff, and then half just general. What is satisfaction to you? So I guess they're asking like what makes me satisfied in terms of life. And number one, the answer is that this is different for absolutely everyone. We all have different goals. We all have different things that we are trying to achieve. But in my opinion, from a very general standpoint, without getting too into this, because I could talk about this for like 40 minutes, the best definition of, not necessarily satisfaction, but success that I've ever heard of.
The best definition of success I've ever found goes like this. Success is the progressive realization of a worthy goal. That's a beautiful definition of success. It means that anyone who's on course toward the fulfillment of a goal is successful. Success doesn't lie in the achievement of a goal, although that's what the world considers success. It lies in the journey toward the goal.
Okay guys, in Melbourne now, boarding my flight in an hour, but in the meantime, getting some work done, getting a video done, multitasking, all day, every day. there's like literally like 200 questions or something in a matter of like a few hours. This is definitely a lot more than I anticipated, so thank you to you guys. How many exercises should you do for each muscle group? Okay, the number of exercises you do, it doesn't necessarily matter. What you have to understand is that when you're putting together like a workout or a training program, there are certain boxes that you need to check off. For example, you need to train each muscle group ideally two times per week. In most cases is more than enough. So that's number one. Number two is you need to train each muscle group for 40 to 70 reps in total per actual session. Now, how you do that doesn't really matter. This could theoretically be something as little as 4 sets of 10. That's 40 reps, that's it. Now, 40 is on the lower end of the rep range. You can do something like 2 exercises, and it could be like 3 sets of 10, and then 4 sets of 10, and that gives you a total of 70 reps. So technically, it's only 2 exercises per muscle group. Now, the point is, guys, how you structure this, you know, whether it be 3 sets of 8, 4 sets of 10, 3 sets of 12, all this stuff is completely up to you, as long as you satisfy these basic requirements, 40 to 70 reps in total per workout, per session for each muscle group, biceps, chest, deltoids, whatever, and as long as you train that muscle group, ideally 2 to 3 times at most per week, it doesn't matter how many exercises you do. That's when people ask me, like, what is the perfect amount of reps or sets or the perfect amount of exercises? It's impossible to tell. It's different depending on the way you structure your program. As long as it fits within this general, kind of these ranges, this general outline of a workout program, you're fine. If you were to have a different career outside of the fitness industry, what would it be? So before fitness, I was working in finance. I was working in a bank. It's kind of like an investment firm. It's a little bit more commercial. To be honest, I'd probably be doing that because it was good progression. It was a respectable career. You know, it was in a great location, great pay for a guy my age. Usually people graduate from college. In this day and age, in our generation, they can't even find a job. It's a very competitive market out there. Due to a combination of, well, downright luck and my ability to like, kind of like, I'm pretty good at interviews and I'm pretty good at making myself seem a lot smarter than I actually am. In doing so, I was able to get a pretty good job out of school. My starting salary was like, I know a lot of people are like, oh, you can't talk about that. It's so taboo. I don't give a shit. You know, I feel like this whole like philosophy about how no one should, there's a couple things that people don't talk about. They don't talk about their age, they don't talk about their weight, they don't talk about their salary. I don't really understand why, or I don't really give a shit. When I graduated outside of school, I was earning about 55K. They bumped that up to about 62K annually after my first year. It was a good job, but I wasn't that, you know, crazy passionate about it, as I've talked in the past. So I pretty much told myself, once YouTube started picking up, once the prospect of potentially being the cured, turning this into a career, I told myself, okay, I'm gonna try my best. I'm gonna throw myself into YouTube, into business, into online coaching, into all of these different, you know, facets that come around social media, and try to make this into a career. And over the last year or so, it's been very successful. So I'm pretty happy, and I don't regret it in any way, and I don't plan on turning back anytime soon. However, I actually told myself, after I quit my job and I started doing this whole YouTube thing seriously full time, I told myself, Igor, go for it, and if it works out, great. But if it doesn't, you're not gonna go back here. My actual goal was to go back to school and go back to engineering. I've always had a passion. I've always been very interested in like the physical sciences, but not physical sciences, like physique. I mean like actual physics, chemistry, probably somewhere in the energy sector. Clean energy, geothermal energy, hydro energy, nuclear energy. What is the best way to hit your daily protein macro goal while on a budget? Honestly, guys, I know that this is gonna seem like, oh, Igor's only saying that because he's sponsored, but no, if you actually go and you look at you break down the numbers and you look at grams of protein per $1 of all the different protein sources out there, beef, chicken, fish, supplements is by far number one. There is more protein in whey protein powder per one like US dollar. I actually once did the calculations. It's not just a little bit, it's like double than things like chicken breast. All right, guys, so now on my way to check in for the Dubai flight. One trip down, 2 to go, 1/3 of the way there. Just ignore the fact that the first flight was 2 hours and the next flight's 14. Other than that, 1/3 of the way there.
Okay, 14-hour flight. Done, landed in Dubai. I have like an hour layover and then another 9-hour flight. This one's 9 hours, that's not too bad.
But I got one question which I wanna answer, and I wanna take a little bit of time on this because it's very important and it's definitely gonna affect at least a few of you guys out there. So someone asked, what do I do about, actually, I think a lot of people asked. I think I got this at least 2 or 3 times out of like the 200 questions or comments I got. 2 or 3 of these were related to this. But someone asked, what do I do with stretch marks? Is there any way to minimize them? And how do I grow without getting stretch marks? And unfortunately, the only answer that I know of, and I'm not an expert on this because I've never had stretch marks because I never got them, and I guess this pertains to why I never got them, grow slowly. But that's a crappy answer, and I don't recommend that. Why would you want to grow slowly? Why would you want to minimize or inhibit the amount of muscle that you gain, the amount of strength that you gain, and overall, in general, like physical development? Why would you want to inhibit it? Why would you want to slow it down? In my opinion, I say go for it. Stretch marks, yeah, they suck, but you have to look at it from a positive standpoint. Try to look at everything from a positive light. Everything can have, you know, it's like there's two sides to every coin. And in this one, it's a big positive. I think that a lot of people don't remember this. I had a friend who, he like dirty bulked and he got a little fat, but he also got really big, really strong. Like I went from benching one plate to like repping 225 within like a year and a half. And he had a lot of stretch marks. But in my opinion, stretch marks are freaking awesome. Conceptually, guys, what do you think they mean? Stretch marks means that your body literally grew in muscle too fast to the point where it's almost like bursting at the seams. Your body literally could not keep up, you know, building skin, replicating like skin cells at the pace required because you're growing so much. It's literally, you're growing muscle faster than the rest of your body can keep up. It's like, you know, if there's skin cells and then there's muscle cells, the muscle cells are like, get the fuck up, let's go. And your skin cells are just like, come on, I can't do it. That's friggin' cool. That is awesome thing. It's almost an accomplishment. It's kind of like battle scars. It signals to me you kicked ass so hard in the gym and in your nutrition and everything that you did that your body could not keep up with your development, and that's pretty damn cool. A little part of me actually envies you because it means that you put on that much muscle that fast, and I never did that. I kind of took it slow. And I got to where I am today, but it took me 11 years. But maybe if I did it in 2, 3, or 4 years, I would have had those stretch marks that you have. I would have had those battle scars that you have. That's kind of badass.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Emirates Flight EK4072.
Scoop of chocolate caramel. A lot of people ask me what my favorite flavor is. Chocolate caramel, end of story. That's it. It's funny, I was just sitting down there and this lady walks by and she's kind of like, hey, you know, that looks like a little creature. And I'm kind of like, I'm right here, I have feelings. And then she said she's talking about the, I don't know how to describe this, the tripod with the microphone, it looks like a spider. I'm like, okay, that makes a lot more sense.
One eternity later.
Good evening there, you want some crumpets and tea from jolly old London? Oh, I've already messed that up. Hey guys, I am in Manchester. This is the final leg of my journey, 36 hours later. Welcome to the UK, the home of Body Power 2017. I'm gonna be at the biggest fitness expo in all the UK, and I think pretty much in all of Europe, this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. I'm gonna be there with Team My Protein all 3 days. I'm pretty much gonna be there the entire time from like 10 till 6 o'clock at night. The Arnold Australia was my first ever expo with the team. I went with Alphalete, and it was fantastic. Like, I loved it, it was awesome. And it was, you know, it was a lot bigger than I anticipated. But apparently Body Power is supposed to be ridiculous. I heard there's supposed to be 120,000 people over the course of the 3 days. So if you guys are in or around Birmingham, I would love it if you stop by because I love meeting you guys. Like at the Arnold Australia, one of the best things was I could talk to you guys and you know, see the people behind like this black box that, you know, I'm talking to, but actually meet the individuals and talk to you guys about fitness, nutrition. You know, I've talked to guys who are like, you know, 10-year veterans of physique and bodybuilding, or people who are like, I stepped into the gym for the first time, like, you know, a few weeks ago, and they're just completely noobs to all of this. Or I talk to people about, you know, not even fitness, not even nutrition. I talk to them about like Dragon Ball Z. Overall, it's awesome because it's so interesting how, you know, you guys are from all over the world. You all have a unique story or personality, a reason for why you're interested in health, fitness, nutrition. And I wanna know why that is. I wanna hear your story. I wanna meet you guys. I wanna see and meet the people behind the lens, behind YouTube. You know, not just the likes, the comments, the views, all these random numbers just flashing by like, tick, tick, tick. Okay, that's great and all, but see the people, meet the people behind. Also guys, one last thing I wanna mention, that edit in the beginning of the video, I hope you guys enjoyed it. That was from Athletics and Aesthetics, as he's known on social media. His name is Isaac, he's from Australia. He came all the way down to the Gold Coast. We hit a workout together. He edited and filmed that workout and it turned out so friggin' cool. It's not that often that I have a pretty damn good workout edit, so when he made that for me, I had to throw up on the channel. Props to him. He's worked with some pretty big names and some pretty damn good physiques in the fitness industry, such as my Alphalete teammate, Emily Hayden, also Mike Rashid. So if you guys are interested, I'll leave a link to his channel down in the description box below, and I'll see you guys in my next video from Body Power 2017, unless you're gonna be there, in which case, see you this weekend.